Om, namaste to all. Another interesting topic. This is a short video I am making, and as I tell always, whatever knowledge I am sharing with you, whatever knowledge I have gained in my life is only due to the blessings of my Guruji Swami Ram Swarupji Yogacharya. He lives in Himachal Pradesh. He is a learned of Vedas, a philosopher of Vedas, an Ashtanga yogi, and a living legend. So the question is, avatar, God's avatar in Kali Yuga is going to come. Is it going to come or not? So basically we have to understand the Vedas are fundamental knowledge of Almighty God and the God's own knowledge given at the time of universe creation. And Vedas says God does not take any form. God does not take any bodily form. And Veda says na jatah na janushyati, that God never takes birth in the past, present or future. And na tasya pratima asti, he does not have any statue, he does not have any measurement possible. We cannot measure God as 1 meter, 2 meter, 3 meter, 1 kilometer, 2 kilometer, so many kilograms, so many tons, etc. So this God is beyond measurement. And also Ajurveda 40/4 says that the human mind, the human brain, the sense organs, the perception organs, these cannot perceive God, because God is so minute that even the sense organs or mind even cannot perceive that formless Almighty God. So avatarvad, for avatar to happen, avatar actually means in Sanskrit is coming down from top, let's say coming down from the akash, and then coming into the garbha of the mother to take a birth. That is called avatar. And people say Sri Ram is a avatar of God, Sri Krishna is avatar of God, then Kali Yuga, Kalki avatar will come, all those things. But this is all Puranic stories. Never in Valmiki Ramayana, Valmiki Muni has never mentioned Sri Ram as avatar. And in Mahabharat, Vyas Muni has never mentioned Sri Krishna as avatar. And neither there is a reference of Kalki avatar or any avatar in Vedas. As I told earlier, Vedas does not have any stories of whatsoever. And neither any place name is mentioned in Vedas. So Vedas are absolutely speaking only about knowledge of science, knowledge of deeds, knowledge of medical science, knowledge of music. Every knowledge is mentioned in Vedas. So avatarvad is, that is why it's not possible. And Sri Ram, Sri Krishna were great dignitaries. Even my Guruji says these two people are the two eyes of the Bharat Mata. But they are not avatar. They lived their life according to Vedas, and they proved that, established the dharma by way of living life as per Vedas. And they learned Vedas from their gurus, and they did everyday yajna morning and evening without fail, and they did intense ashtanga yoga tapasya, and thereby they realized Almighty God. So Ram and Krishna was never avatar. And also my Guruji has beautifully written in Upanishad, it says tat srishtva tadev anupravishat. Anu means afterwards. That means this God enters into the universe after creating this universe. That means like I build a house, after building the house I enter into the house. Similarly, this universe is created by Almighty God, and anupravishat means afterwards God enters into the universe and he becomes omnipresent inside the universe. And also my Guruji has mentioned, Upanishad says, without God entering into this universe, without God being omnipresence, sun, moon, water, earth, fire, nothing can work. Even sun will exist in the akash, in the sky, but it will not shine because the power of God is making it shine. That is the secret of Vedas, which the modern science cannot know. And similarly, so for God to take an avatar, he has to come out of this creation and go into the womb of a mother. But you know, God is already omnipresent. He is already present inside the womb of mother. How can he come down from somewhere to be inside the womb of mother, to take birth as inside the womb of mother? But let's say for argument's sake, if God has to take a birth, then he has to have this full universe. He has to remove his power and come into a body form. If he removes his power into come into a body form, this universe cannot sustain. This is what Veda says. And also, God says there has to be a reason for everything. Even the knowledge of Vedas, God says that this knowledge is emanates directly from Almighty God without speaking. God did not speak this knowledge to the rishis. God did not write with pen and pencil and gave this knowledge to Rishi Munis. He, by his own power, he creates this universe, this Vedic knowledge inside the heart of the four rishis with his power. So that is the Almighty God power, and in this entire universe is created by Almighty God's very very small power as mentioned in Yajurveda 31st chapter Purusha Sukta 3rd mantra. A very small minutest power of God acts on the non-alive Prakriti, and this entire non-alive universe is made. This universe is non-alive, it is Jada Tattva, it is not live alive Tattva. So this is what my Guruji has explained to people. And also in Yajurveda mantra 23:56, there is a question in the mantra that who encloses the whole world, and the answer is given by God himself, that God gives that this, it is the Prakriti in which at the time of final destruction the whole world is hidden. So the whole world is Jada, and then this whole non-alive world will is hidden inside the Prakriti at the time of final destruction, and it is not hidden inside the God, because nothing is created out of God. Because if this world is created out of God, then the world will also be non-destructible by God, by like God. So this we have to understand. So that is why avatarvad is not possible, and Kalki avatar is going to happen in Kali Yuga. This is all false stories. Kalki avatar will not happen, will not take there is no avatarvad that is going to come. If at all we have to establish the dharma, it is up to each and every individual to follow the Vedic dharmic path. It is not a religious, it's not, I'm not saying the religion Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, Isai, Parsi, Jain, etc. I'm speaking about the Vedic dharma by which each and every individual we have to follow. Thereby the dharma will be re-established in this universe, in this world. That is the only way this this dharma can be re-established, not by any avatar. So that's all for today. I will try to meet you soon in another interesting video. Thank you so much. If you like this channel, please subscribe, please forward to your friends. And if you have any questions, please visit our website. The answers are given directly from my Guruji Swami Ram Swarupji at www.vedmandir.com. Thank you so much. Namaste. Om.